Hi guys, so in today's video we're going to build a secured app using either fingerprints, face ID or touch ID to authenticate users. So for this and more, let's dive into it. Alright, so as usual, I've already set up my project, which I'm not going to cover that in this video. I already have a video on that, so if you're interested in learning how to set up your React Native projects, I'm going to leave the link down below. You can check it out, and then once you are done setting up your project, I think we are good to go. So the first thing we are going to do is install the library or package that is required for this project. So I'm just going to go to Expo Docs and then search for Expo Local Authentication, right? And then we are going to look at how to install this particular library. So we are just going to copy this command, right? And then go back to our projects and then open our terminal. So we are going to paste it here and then press enter to install it. I'm not going to do that because I've already installed it. Okay, so once you are done installing it, let's head over back to the documentation. We need to also include this library in our plugin. So what you are going to do is you are going to copy this section of the code, right? And then we'll go back to our projects. We are going to open our app.json file, scroll down here, okay, and then we are going to paste the plugin right here. Okay, so if you already have plugin in your projects, all you need to do is copy this array and then paste it in here, right? But then if you don't have the plugin, you have to include the plugin as well and then save it. So this is basically how we are going to set up the library. Now, once you are done, I think we are good to go. The next thing is to import the library, okay? So we are just going to import this library at the top here, right? And then, before we proceed, let's start our Metro bundler, okay? So I'm just going to type npm run start and then press enter. This is going to start our bundler for us. All right, so our Metro bundler is ready. And our QR code is available. So I'm just going to scan the QR code using my Expo Goal application. Yeah, and as you can see, the application is building, right? So let's bring this one down and then let's wait for it. Okay. Great, so we can see the welcome back text showing, right? Now let's proceed. Alright, so now that we are done installing and also we've imported the library here, I think we can proceed to look into some of the methods, right? But before that, let me point out this. So there are some limitations, okay? Currently, when you're using iOS, so it says the Face ID authentication for iOS is not supported in Expo Go, right? So you just have to bear it in mind. If you want to go ahead with that, you will need to probably create a build. Then you test your face ID on that, okay, which is basically creating your own Expo Goal application, right? Yeah, so I think if you are using Android or you are using an emulator and then you don't want to test the face ID, I think we can proceed, okay? So now let's look at some of the methods. So when you look at this section, right, we have a couple of methods which we are going to look into each and every one of them, okay? So, let's go back to our code, right? Let me just do a quick code here. So use effects, and then inside it, let me define some function. Let's say func. So this function is where I'm going to do my stuff. Then I'm going to call it here, then run it once. Now the next step is to find out whether our device has the necessary components that are required for this particular authentication, right? So let's go back to the documentation, right? And then when you look through the methods, we have has hardware, right? And then when you read about it, it says it determines whether a face or a fingerprint scanner is available on your device, right? So this is the method that we are going to look into. So I'm just going to come inside the func and then paste this code, right? Let me make the func an async, and then let's save this. Okay, let me open this a little bit. Let me scroll down right here. So what I'm going to do is come down here, right? And let's try and console log. Let's try and console log the compatible, right? Or whatever we are getting from the method. Okay. And then let's save it. Great. So as you can see, you are getting true. And when you hover over it, it says it determines whether a fingerprint or a face ID scanner is available on the device, and it returns a promise, okay, which is Boolean. So we are getting true, which means our device has the necessary components for this particular authentication, right? Now let's proceed. The next method we are going to look into is the asynroad async, right? Where is it? Right. So it determines whether our device has some saved fingerprints or facial data. In order to proceed, your device has to have a saved fingerprint or facial data. Currently, I have the two, okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste this particular code here, which has the asynroad async here. And let me just bring comma here and then paste the saved biometrics here. Let's save this. Great. So it also confirms that currently I have both of them, but if you have either one of them is still going to return true. Okay. Yeah, we can also look at the biometric types that we've actually subscribed to, okay, or we've actually saved data about. So let's look at the next method, which is the support authentication type async, right? And let me copy this and bring it down here, right? And let's save this. Now when we save it, we can see we have in the terminal, we can see we have an array which is 1 and 2. Okay, let's go back to the method and then scroll down here and then look for async types, right? So when you look at async types, we have fingerprints, we have facial recognition and iris, right? And each of them, we denote them with a number. So you have 1, 2, and 3. When we come here, we can see we have 1 and 2, so it means we have fingerprints and facial recognition biometric data saved in our system, right? So if you've already, let's say, done fingerprint authentication on your physical device, you should have only the first one, right? If you've done the other way around, which is the facial recognition, you should have only the two in this particular array. Okay, yeah, so we can also look at the types from here. So we have the authentication types, right? And then here I can see facial recognition. Let's save it. You can see we have 2 here. When we change it to fingerprints, we have 1, and then iris right here, we have 3. Okay, so currently we could say that, or you could see that my physical device only has the facial and then the fingerprint, right? I mean, it's good, so we can proceed. Now the last method that we are going to talk about is the authentication or authenticate async function, right? So this function actually triggers the authentication, right? And it returns some value, so we can see results here. Great. And then let's save this. Great. So now on my physical device, you can see we have this pop-up modal which says we should select either fingerprint or facial, right? Now when I go with fingerprints, and I touch on my fingerprint scanner, you can see it disappears, right? Which means we've authenticated. But to justify that, let's clear these things, right? Or let's replace them with the results. Okay, let me save this. Great. So it comes again. Let me wait. And as you can see in the terminal, don't know if I can increase the terminal size, but yeah, as you can see in the terminal, we have this object which has the success as true, right? Let's try it again. Let me change something in here and just save it. Now when I cancel it, great, you see we are getting error, which is user cancelled. We are getting success, which is false. Warning is authentication cancelled, right? So depending on the action of the user, the object or the resource is going to change, right? So let me bring this back to default, right? So these are basically the methods that are required for this particular project. Okay, I mean, you can also pass in a couple of props here, which includes the prop message, right? You can pass in a other props, you can check them later. You can have the fallback label, required confirmation, and all that. So these are the methods that we are going to use for this particular project. Okay, so now that we know the fundamentals, I'm just going to paste the end product or end results, and then we'll quickly go through it. All right, so this is the end product, and I would like to say, don't worry about the UI stuff, right? Let's just focus about the logic, and then later on you can just grab the code on my GitHub repo and then tweak it however you want it. Okay, so the main important thing, or the main guy here, is the local authentication, okay, which is the Expo local authentication. So we are importing it here, okay, and then here we are defining some states. So it's authenticated, biometric, so it's biometric supported, biometric types, and then loading, right? So these are the states that we are defining here. Here too, we are getting some animation values for fading, scaling, and pause, right? And then in here we have the use effect. The latter part of the use effect is basically for animations, right? The first one, which is the check biometric support, is what we are interested in. So let's go to that particular function, and this is it. Okay, so the whole idea or the goal of this method is to check whether our application or our device supports our biometric authentication. Okay, so here we check for compatibility, which we've already talked about, and then if it's true, then we go into this particular if statement, right? If it's true, then we go ahead and then check whether we have some saved biometric. If we don't, then we just alert the user that biometric record not found. Now if it passes this stage, then it means at least we have some either fingerprint, iris, or facial data in our system or on our device. Okay, once it passes that edge or that state, then we now proceed to the biometric types. We then fetch the biometric types that we've actually subscribed to on our physical device. Okay, in my case, I have both fingerprints and then facial recognition, so I pass in some if else statement here. Okay, so if it includes facial, then I just set my biometric type to fingerprint and returns, right? If it doesn't include fingerprint, but then it includes facial recognition, then I set it to facial or face ID. Okay, else I set it to biometric, and once you are done with the check-ins, right? That is basically how it goes. Now we have the start pause animation function. We are not interested in this one, right? You also have the handle biometric authentication, okay, which we are going to talk about next. So what this one does is it checks whether it's biometric support, and then once it passes through that stage, we set loading to true, and then we call our authenticate async right here. We pass in these props, okay, which we've already talked about, and then we check if the resource has success, right? If the success is true, then we go ahead and then change our is authenticated state and then perform some animations. That is basically what is happening here. Yeah, so the next thing is the handle logout function, right, which basically changes the is authenticated state and then start some pause animations, right? After that, we do some conditional rendering here. So if it's authenticated, then we display this particular UI or component, which has the welcome, this text in here, and then it also has the logout button right here. But then if it's not authenticated, then it goes down to the main component or the main screen, which has this information here, right? And here we provide a button, right? Once you click on this particular button, it starts the authentication process, right? And then beneath it, we show some text as well, which are not really interested. All right, so this is the moment of truth. And as you can see on our physical device, we have this nice UI showing, okay? So I'm just going to click on the fingerprint button, right? And then for a second, we have the modal. So I'm just going to use the fingerprints. And as you can see, it displays that we've actually logged in or we are authenticated, okay? We can click on the logout button and let me try and use a different approach, which is the facial. Great, and then confirmed, right? Yeah. So I think, yeah, that is it, and I hope you really enjoyed this video. If you did, kindly click on the subscribe button, like this video, share the video with friends, and see you in the next one. Happy coding.